Hi, I'm Laurence Clement. I'm the Program Director of Academic Career Development at the University of California, San Francisco in the Office of Career and Professional Development. And today I'm presenting the second video in a series called the Strategic Postdoc, and we're working on Module 1, Positioning Yourself for the Postdoc. And this video is about the fact that we want you to start at the end when designing your professional development. We want you to ground your plans by first looking ahead at your career goals. To explain this, I'm going to start with two examples that we often see in our work as advisors at UCSF. These are typical postdoc situations we run into and we help people with. And so I'm going to talk about Lily, who is 5 years into her postdoc and she wants to be a tenure track faculty at a research intensive institution. And she knows that she needs to write a research statement for her faculty application, but she's not sure what to propose in her research project. She's mostly worked on her PI's work until now. And so she's not really sure what to pitch as an independent research project. And we also have another situation that's pretty common, which is Carlos. In this case, we chose that a situation where Carlos has been a postdoc for 4 years, and it's clear to him that he doesn't want a research intensive faculty position, but that he'd like to attend more professional development so he can explore careers beyond academia, or he could also teach at an undergraduate institution to find out if a position at a primarily undergraduate institution is the right fit for him. And so the issue for Carlos in this case is that his PI isn't very supportive of him spending too much time outside the lab, and he's not sure how to negotiate that. And the reason why Lily and Carlos are in this situation is because they didn't design their training from the end. And what they did is that they didn't think about how to backward design their training and how to really think about their career goals. Because in reality, there is more than one postdoc in academia. And there's this misconception in academia that everyone should do the same type of postdoc. But it really depends on your career goals. And it really depends also on what you learned in graduate school and what you know already. And so when you think about the different types of postdocs, there are postdocs that prepare you for a research intensive faculty position. There are postdocs that prepare you for faculty positions at primarily undergraduate institutions like that have a lot of research and teaching. There are positions that prepare you for scientists, positions in industry. And there are also postdocs where you actually train and you actually explore your career before you start training for a career. And we're going to talk about these different scenarios. And if you think about Lily and Carlos, they are at different points in the timeline that we would expect they would have for these different postdocs. And if you look specifically at Carlos, he's actually beyond the amount of time you really needed to train for these two career goals that he's considering. One thing that's really important to remember is that many careers are accessible without a postdoc. And these careers can be careers in industry, in government, and even in academia, whether they're faculty or not faculty positions, there are many positions you can access without your postdoc. And we're gonna talk about this a little bit more. One thing I want you to really think about is that there's actually a cost to the postdoc for the trainee. So for example, for Carlos, who's thinking of potentially an industry position, he could actually have given up to 21% of his income over the first 15 years of his career. And that is something that was discussed in a paper by Khan et al. In Nature Biotechnology in 2017. So really what you want to think about is that you want to find the right postdoc for your career goals. And you also want to think about the fact that if you're not sure about what type of career you really want to engage in, you should really prioritize this career exploration early on in your career. You should really start now exploring careers, and you should actually make that a priority as part of your weekly schedule as you move forward with your training, so that very quickly you can make a decision about what type of career is really the right fit for you. Because if you think about it, if you decide to go for the longer postdoc that requires more training, the research intensive postdoc for a faculty position, you might miss some windows of deadlines that are associated with some grant funding opportunities that will increase your chances of getting that position. For example, the NIH K99 grant is an example that has of a funding mechanism that has a very short timeline, a window for you to apply for. So the other thing that we really want postdocs or graduate students to do is to reframe their postdoc as a training. When you think about it, the postdoctoral training is supposed to be originally a training for a very, very competitive type of position, the faculty at a research intensive institution. And it's very much like training for, you know, high level sports or art forms. Because I'm French, when I think of training for a competitive sport, I think of soccer. So I made a parallel here between training for a research position and training for becoming a competitive soccer player. So if you think about it, the postdoc is a training that prepares for a career. And if you are already prepared for this career, then you do not need the postdoctoral training. So you really need to know what career you're preparing for. Just like soccer, it ends with a competition. And in this case, it's for a position. And again, if you're already competitive for this position, you do not need postdoctoral training. The other thing is that if you do decide that you do need training, you need to be really clear on what the goal is so you can get a shot at that position. So you really need to be very clear about what your goals are when engaging in a postdoctoral training. And very few trainees actually have that in mind when they start their postdoc. Not very few, but a lot of trainees actually do not think about that when they start their training. So the first question you're going to have to ask yourself with this is, what types of careers are most appealing to me? But you might also be considering other things when you're deciding which careers to go for. It might have to do with the inclusivity of the workplace or the type of work environment. It might have to do with your personal or your community values. And if you are still considering this and still thinking about this, I recommend that you go back to our first video in Module 1 about acknowledging your preferences, your needs, and your values, and making career choices based on all of these parameters. The other thing is that if you're going to be applying for faculty positions, you need to be aware that there are different types of faculty positions. And that was pretty clear from what Lily and Carlos were going through. Lily wanted a position at a research intensive institution, which I'm going to call R throughout this video series, where when you want to get tenure at that institution, you have to be really strong in research. So in publications, in grant funding, you have to be very productive on the research side. And there might be some teaching involved in that position. But the majority of the decision-making factors of how we hire these faculty is based on their research. There are also a big category of institutions in the US that have both research and teaching, and they actually decide on tenure for their faculty by weighing both the research and the teaching pretty heavily. Some of them are much more research-focused and others are more teaching-focused. We're going to talk about those nuances later in the video series, but I'm going to talk about these institutions as RT, which is what Carlos is interested in. And then there are also teaching only institutions that, again, are some of those institutions that may not require for you to complete a postdoctoral training at all. And these are institutions either at community colleges or some smaller, primarily undergraduate institutions that have very little research. And many of them are going to really make their tenure decision based on your teaching and your ability to support diversity. And so again, it's a very different training that you would have for these positions, but that training might actually be mostly in graduate school, although postdocs do apply to these positions. So if you want to find out more about these three types of positions, you might want to check out the Academic Career Readiness Assessment and the paper that we wrote in CBLSC and that describes the different types of institutions, how to find which institutions fit in which category, and to know more about how they make their hiring decisions, which we'll talk more in details about in the next few videos. And the last thing you should do when you're thinking about reframing the postdoc as a training is to think about the fact that it requires a coach and a strategy, like in soccer. And so you're going to have to find the right mentor for the postdoctoral position that you need to complete. and come up with a really good training strategy that gets you to your objective. And we'll talk more about this in our next video, which is building a game plan, where we're going to talk more in more details about how to backward design your training and come up with a postdoctoral training strategy. Thank you.